Sure. I was about 9 pounds lighter than I am now. I'm 180, so I'm
saying. She thought something was going on.
She's like, are you okay, Uncle Chad? I'm fine, baby.
I'm telling you, those fans will tell you in a heartbeat.
Oh, right in a heartbeat. And I was like, no, I ain't sick like that, baby. Trust me. She said, well, I'm going to see you next time you come to Charlotte. I said, okay. But she was all nervous.
Yeah. Your show, man, you are hanging with, like, women who look to be all of 27 years old.
Oh, that's about right for everybody in my band. That's most of them.
Really?
Most of them.
And your wife is like, yep, that's.
Yeah, that's about the size of it.
And you're going with them. Like, I'm
slowing down a little bit now.
You said, everything.
Let me tell you something, Tam. I've been slowing down for maybe last year and a half because, you know, but I had fallen ill with bronchitis and all that. Had me a little bound down a little bit. But I used to have them breathing out of oxygen tanks.
I don't know when to believe you
in between songs.
So, are you breathing out of oxygen tanks, or they are?
They were.
They were?
Yeah.
The girls?
Yes. But I am now. I ain't gonna never lie to you. I'm a realist. I'm gonna keep it real.
I'm gonna tell you.
I'm gonna tell you everything that's right and what's real. But yeah, I go back there and change clothes, and for at least 2 minutes, I'm breathing.
Through the oxygen tank.
Yes.
Does it help?
Oh, yeah. That stuff's dangerous, though. You're not supposed to be breathing like that.
Well, I was going to say, I've never breathed through an oxygen tank before, so I didn't know if it actually assists incredibly.
Yeah, see the basketball players when they sit down and they put the mask on. Sometimes they take a couple of whiffs.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's about it, you know.
Oh, okay.
You ain't supposed to be just... Because it's dangerous.
Right.
It's like a drug, they told me. The guy said, you don't need much of this. Just, just take a couple of breaths and...
And you'll be all right. And go on back out there and sing the song.
And one time this guy was an ENT. He's like, are you okay? I said, are you okay? He said, no, are you okay? I said, are you okay? So we was back and forth. Then I started laughing. He stopped. I'm serious. I said, I am too. Do you want some of this? He was like, no, I'm fine. I said, I am too. I'm just going to take one whiff. And I said, you ever seen somebody like me work across? He said, how old are you? I said, just stand right there and watch it. You tell me when I get back how old you think I am. I tease them all the time. They come in there. I just want to check. I said, you don't need to check nothing right now. My heart's fine. Everything's fine. I'm going to take a deep hit of that when I come back after about six songs, and I'll take a whiff of that, and then they be like, are you okay? I'm so fine.
Yeah, you're amazing on that stage, and I have to say, Shanice, go and bring me my food. I'm good. Bring me my food. I'm hungry. Yeah. This is my birthday.
Look at the plate they bringing you, baby. Look at that. Damn, look at that.
Look, Uncle Charlie, I figure since you working and you taking over, I can eat.
You sure can. But I noticed they went right past me and came straight to you.
They did.
I'm watching that. Don't dare bring me a plate now. As a matter of fact, when you go out, turn left and don't come back. Steven, they won't feed me.
KJLH, you're on with Tammy Mack and Uncle Charlie taking over.
Yeah.
Hi, Tammy. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, babe.
I don't know if you remember me, but my son, John Michael, is like your biggest fan. He was your fan since he was a baby at 10 months old. He's now 15 years old.
Mm.
And he's like met you a couple of times. Every time you come down to the radio station, I always call you to ask you, could he do a meet and greet with you? Mm. And you promised him like so many times, but nothing's ever went through.
Mm. Where's he at?
He's at school now, but he's on his way home.
Okay.
And I'm just like calling just to ask you if there's anything you can do, if you can meet with him or something. Because the last year has been really hard for our family. We lost my mom last August.
Oh, wow.
And
sorry,
like,
my condolences to you.
We're just like living each day, but I really wanted to know if he could come to the concert, because I know every time you do your shows, you always take us to church, and that's something we really need right now, because it's like each day is really hard for us, because it's like I don't even know if we're going to have a place to live next month, because since my mom passed away, everything has been really hard for us, so... The last time you've done shows, we've like had a chance to go to the fair and all of that, but since my mom has been gone and I was like her caregiver, she was like the main person who supported us, but with her gone, it's like we're just barely struggling now to pay rent and to eat and everything else.
Wow.
You hold on the line, all right?
Yeah, hold on. Okay.
Hold on the line. Wow. I'm sure, Uncle Charlie, you get a lot of that. You get a lot of stories from people about how you uplift them, how you motivate them. How Absolutely. Do you deal with people coming to you with what's going on in their life? How does that, what kind of mindset does that put you in?
Well, basically, first of all, as soon as I hear something that could be heartbreaking, or I just right away start praying for them. Mm. In my mind, in my heart, I just close my eyes. You know, I'm always wearing dark shades, so I close my eyes and ask God to do something about this situation, because He know everything that goes on. So I'm like, Lord, you see this family and whatever it is, I ask you to make sure that they can overcome whatever this is in their lives. And you know, sometimes I get a return on the next show that I come to the city, and they was like, oh, remember we came to see you? And uh-huh. I'm like, yeah, we got a new house, we got this. And I was like, I said, I already know. She said, how you know? Because I asked God to do it.
There it is. Mm-hmm. There it is. Radio Free, you're on with Tammy Mack and the Charlie Wilson Takeover.
Yep.
Hey, Charlie Wilson. Hey, Tammy Mack.
Hey.
I have to tell you, today is my 60th birthday.
All right,
and
baby.
I met Charlie Wilson in 1986.
Where was we at?
You pulled up in this limo. Wait a minute. You pulled up in a limo. We and my best friend was at the gas station. And you was like, hey, we was like, hey, what is that dude from the gas station? So I just want to say thank you, Charlie. You have been a long-standing songwriter and a singer. And we love you.
Thank you so much.
Everybody out there from Compton loves you. Yeah. I just want to say happy birthday, too, to you, Tammy Mack.
Thank you so much.
Like
thank
hell you, to get some tickets on Thursday.
Okay, all well, right. You might be able to get some, because we are going to play the Radio Free music quiz, and you can phone a friend, and that friend will be Charlie Wilson for the game. So keep listening to find out when you can call, because we're going to play in a minute. Charlie, we got to play some music. What do you want to hear after this commercial break?
Did I hear the part in my song? I didn't. You know, my favorite part, the ooh wee and the shabba dabba. In the
Forever Valentine song. That new single?
Yeah. I didn't hear my part. I'm sorry. Have we played it already?
Okay.
Can we just play it again?
We're going to play it right after this commercial. Maybe.
Why does the commercial have to wait?
You know what? That's a good question. That's a good question.
Why don't the commercial wait?
Why don't the commercial wait for the music?
Yeah.
Instead of us waiting for the commercial.
Thank you. Because I missed my part.
Well, what was your part? Which part was your part?
Ladies, if you're with the one you love, let me hear you say ooh-wee. And fellas, if you're with the one you love, let me then sing shabba dabba doot doot dwee. Yep, that's it.
I don't need a 14.